Welcome to the video on the epoxide, which is a part of the third semester organic chemistry for BSc students. Let us define water epoxide. Epoxide is a cyclic ether with a three-membered ring and a two-cyclic system. The basic structure of an epoxide contains an oxygen atom which is attached to two adjacent carbon atoms of a hydrocarbon. Cyclic ether, which contains a three-atom ring similar to equilateral triangle, which makes its strength and hence highly reactive more than the other ethers. So, epoxide is a cyclic ether with an oxygen atom, and hence it is called as heterocyclic system. And this oxygen atom is attached to two adjacent carbon atoms of a hydrocarbon. And this cyclic ether resembles to an equilateral triangle, and hence the molecule is highly strained, and hence it is highly reactive when compared to the other ethers. So, this is an example for an epoxide, or it is also referred as oxyring. So, a cyclic ether in which we have an oxygen atom, a three-membered ring, are referred as cyclic ether or the epoxide. So, coming to the nomenclature, although the cyclic ethers have the hypeic name, their common names are more widely used. So, when we want to name according to the IPR, we add a prefix OX, which shows the oxygen in the ring, and the suffixes irene, ethane, olane, and ane show 3, 4, 5, and 6 atoms in a saturated ring. So, with a 3-member containing an oxygen, often called as ethylene oxide or oxyring. With the 4-carbon atom, we call it to be the oxetane. So, we add a prefix OX and ETAN for 4-member carbon. Likewise, we call for a 5-member oxolane hexa, we call it to be the oxoane. When we have 2 oxygen, it is called as 1,4-dioxane. This is all about the nomenclature of the cyclic ethers. Coming to the synthesis of epoxide by Drazen's method. So, the Drazen method, which is also known as Drazen's condensation or glycidic ester condensation, is a chemical reaction of a ketone or an aldehyde with a alpha haloester in the presence of a base like sodium alkoxide or sodamide to form an alpha beta epoxy ester, and we call it to be a glycidic ester. This reaction was discovered by the organic chemist Augusta Georges Drazen in 1904. So, the epoxide can be synthesized by the Drazen's method, which is a reaction of a ketone or an aldehyde with an alpha haloester in the presence of a base, and that results in the formation of an alpha beta epoxy ester, and commonly it is called as glycidic ester. So, this is the reaction. So, here we have taken the ketone propane 2-ol and it is condensed with ethyl 2-chloropropanol in the presence of the base alkoxide to get the alpha beta epoxy ester by Drazen's method. And coming to the reactions of the epoxide, these epoxides are highly strained and they easily undergo ring-opening reaction under both acidic and basic condition. So, when there is a ring-opening either in the acidic or the basic, that results in the formation of an addition product. Coming to the acid-catalyzed opening of epoxide, when an epoxide is treated with a nucleophilic agent which can be a water or OH, Br minus. In the presence of an acid, it undergoes a CO cleavage through SN1 mechanism, and in an unsymmetric epoxide, the acidic cleavage is favored in the direction which generates the most stable carbocation, and it is mediated through the SN1 mechanism. So for an example, when the epoxide is treated in the acidic condition in presence of water, we get a bisphenol diol, or commonly called as a glycol. So same is also true with a 6-member, where we get the same product, a bisphenol diol or a glycol. Coming to the mechanism of the acid catalyzed opening of the oxide. So this is the general representation, where there is a ring opening followed by the SN1 and there is an addition resulting in the product. So the first step here is the epoxide is converted to a protonated epoxide by the acid catalyst. So in the first step, we are going to get a protonated epoxide. The protonated epoxide then undergo a nucleophilic attack by SN1 mechanism, and we get the desired product. So this is all about the mechanism of the acid catalyzed opening of the epoxide. First step is the protonation, followed by the attack of a nucleophile, which follows the SN1 mechanism. And these are the few examples for the acid catalyzed opening of epoxide. So as I said, an epoxide undergo a opening in the presence of an acid or a nucleophilic reagent like a water, HCl, hydrogen, cyanide, in the presence of the acid, and it undergoes a cleavage, and this cleavage is followed by the SN1 nucleophilic reaction resulting in the formation of the desired product. So when an hydrolysis of an epoxide occurs in the presence of water, it results in the formation of the ethylene glycol. Likewise, when an epoxide reacts with an halogen acid, for example hydrochloric acid, we get the ethylene chlorohydrin as the product. And the epoxide also undergo an acidic cleavage in the presence of an hydrogen cyanide, and this results in the formation of ethylene cyanohydrin. And the other examples are when an epoxide reacts with an organic acid, we get the glycol monoacetate as the product. Likewise, when the epoxide reacts with the ethyl glycol, the product here is 2-ethoxyethanol. Coming to the base catalyzed opening of the epoxide. When an epoxide is treated with a strong nucleophilic reagents like sodium ethoxide, sodium phenoxide, ammonia, amines, etc., it also undergo a ring opening, and it results in the corresponding product. Likewise, what we have got in the acid catalyst opening, when an epoxide reacts in the basic condition, we get a bisphenol diol, either in a 3-member or in the 6-member, the product is formed is a diol, so having 2 hydroxyl group on 2 different carbon atoms, and hence we call it to be a bisphenol diol. So let us look at the reactions of the epoxide under basic condition, and here it proceeds via SN2 mechanism. So the nucleophilic attack of the epoxide attacks the epoxide to form an anion. This on protonation will give the substituted alcohol. The non-protonated epoxide is less reactive than a protonated epoxide. The more basic and more strongly nucleophilic reagent compensates its lower reactivity, and here we have to look, it is an SN2 mechanism, and in this reaction, in an unsymmetric ring, the nucleophilic attacks to a less hindered side, and this is favored in the case of an unsymmetric epoxide. Let us look some of the examples for a base catalyzed opening of epoxide. So, when an epoxide reacts with the ethyl alcohol, we get the glycol monoethyl ether. Likewise, when it reacts with the ammonia, we get the corresponding product ethanol amine. And when the epoxide reacts with a primary amine, the product is 2-alkyl aminoethanol. When it reacts with a secondary amine, the product is 2-dialkyl aminoethanol. And when it reacts with the phenol, we get the 2-phenoxyethanol. And these are the few examples for the acid and base catalyzed reaction. And these are the corresponding products. Thank you.